So I thought it was time for some free stuff once again. And this time I'm gonna provide you with some 8, 16 and 35 millimeter film grain overlays. And again, all of that is entirely free. You can download that from my website and the link to that is in the description down below. So once you've downloaded your pack or your packs, if you wanna get all of them, you will get those zip files, the 8, 16 and 35 millimeter zip files. And if you unzip them, you will get those folders, and each of those folders stores 3 overlays. So how you're gonna use those overlays and how you're gonna save them in DaVinci Resolve is what I'm gonna show you in this video. So first you wanna open up DaVinci Resolve and put some footage on your timeline in order to actually see the grain. So then what you wanna do is go to your media pool and create a folder called grain, and then create 3 different folders in the grain folder called 8, 16 and 35 millimeter, and drag the overlays in there accordingly. Or if you want to work a little bit more unorganized, you can just dump all the MOV files straight into your media pool. And let's say I want to use the 8mm, the grunge one, just drag and drop this on my timeline just like so. And right now you can see that we have a gray background with some grain on it. So in order to see our footage through, we have to change the composite mode. And we're going to do that by selecting the clip that we want to change the composite mode. In this case, it's the overlay. We're going to go to the inspector in the top right corner. And then we want to go down to where it says composite and change the composite mode from normal to overlay. And right now you can see that we have a nice grainy image. Let me just make this a full screen viewer so you can see this. Right now you can see the grain, especially in the sky, that it's applied to the footage compared to when it's not applied, let's say like right here. So another good thing about those overlays is that it's actually very easy for your system to playback. So let me just hit play right here and you can see it plays back very smoothly compared to the built-in film grain in DaVinci Resolve or other overlays. And that is because I've rendered them in ProRes 422. And against most beliefs, having like bigger file sizes is actually way easier for your system to playback than having much more compressed file sizes like H.264 or H.265. So all in all, those are super easy to use and playback on pretty much every system. So now you know this, how do we store those assets? Because let's be honest, importing them in each and every project that we're working on is a little bit time consuming and just not very efficient. So what you're gonna do is first of all, go to media pool in top left corner and then go down to where it says power bins. If you don't see the power bins, however, then go up to the top of your screen to where it says view, and then make sure show power bins is checked, because if it's not checked, it won't show up in the media pool. So let's just go in here and check show power bins. And in the power bins, you have your master bin, and there you wanna create a new bin, something like a grain. And in the grain folder, you can just drag and drop the assets that you wanna use, something like this. Another benefit of storing those files in the power bins is I can actually get rid of all of them, just delete them and now grab them from my power bin section, just like straight onto my media timeline. And as you can see, I don't have to change the composite mode, because if you change the composite mode previously and save the changed version into your power bins, it will also save the changes. So I can just go in here and again, just duplicate this, something like that. And then just maybe here. And now, as you can see, I have grain overlaid on top of everything without having to do much work. So that's a wrap. If you enjoyed the product and if you liked this video, please make sure to leave a like and a comment to help me spread out this video even more so more people can benefit from the free assets on my website. That's all I'm asking for. Anyways, hope you're having a great day. See you next time. Bye.